Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning.
Before we start talking about the masks, I wanted to bring up Bill Maher and some Yankees players testing positive after being vaccinated, and also people testing positive after they've had COVID and been vaccinated. What's your response to that?
No surprise. That's what happens. Now, remember, the efficacy rate of a vaccine is who develops symptomatic COVID. And that is 90% with the mRNA vaccines, that's Pfizer and Moderna. It's 72% with the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, all right? So it's 100% effective against getting severe disease, going in the hospital and dying, almost 100%, all right? So what you're seeing here are people who are vaccinated or who had COVID and then got vaccinated. They're basically protected, but they're still getting infection. But most of, if you look closely at that Yankee group, they're very mild infections. And we don't even know how infectious they are. They're likely not infectious for a very long period of time. So the game, the whole playing card has changed. You're gonna see a lot of this, but these people aren't gonna get real sick.
All right, the new mask guideline. I have two questions. One is, shouldn't we be concerned about variants that are more dangerous than the UK variant, like something from India or Brazil? And two, do we need a more substantive proof of vaccination beyond some pen written on a card that's in my wallet?
Yeah, carry your card. You should carry your card. Somebody's going to ask you one of these days. We do have to worry about the variants. The variants are here. But so far, the activity against the variants, some of them, not all of them, is a little bit less, but still it's effective and it still prevents against severe disease that we know of today. Now, that could change, but of course, we're gonna start seeing this. If we start seeing the patients in the hospital now with severe disease in the ICU again, that's the game changer and we go backwards. That's not happening. Who's in the hospital now? Primarily people who didn't take the vaccine. And it's 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s years old people. It's the younger people. The older people are more vaccinated. There are older people in there, but I mean, not very many like it used to be. So it's the whole playing field has changed.
So these cards, do you think we're going to be upgraded to something else? It just seems like something you could Xerox off and just, you know, write in. It doesn't it seem very simplistic, you know, and easily to, you know, fraudulent?
This whole thing, Robin, is, you don't get vaccinated, you're gonna get sick. You're gonna get sick and you're gonna end up in the hospital. And that's your problem. Oh. Well, it's also the healthcare system's problems. Yeah. But if you're vaccinated, whether you have a card in your pocket or not, you're not gonna get that, even if you get infected, you're not gonna get that sick. That's your card. Your card is your protection. And so they basically, I mean, it looks like they've just given up on the card thing. I think for international travel and for certain events, you know, you're going to have to show a card. But, you know, if you're going to fraudulently say, oh, I had the vaccine, you're the one that's going to get sick and end up in the hospital.
Let's talk about where COVID came from. We've talked about this a little bit, and there are all these crazy conspiracy theories out there. But something that seems a bit credible is there are a list of doctors that have signed on to say we need to do a better investigation than what the WHO had done. And I wanted to get your thoughts on whether you think this group of doctors is a credible group of doctors.
First of all, that group in Science Magazine is a very credible group of doctors. There's a representative from the University of Chicago here, Harvard, Yale, Stanford, all the elites, you know, and international ones as well. It's a very credible group. There's no question about that. So, you know, all they're saying is exactly, they're echoing what the WHO committee, which included an American, said. They said, you know, with the evidence that we were seeing, it looks like it's just an evolution of the virus that went through another animal and spread there. It doesn't look like a lab accident, which actually goes along with the epidemiology of the virus and so forth. But even the WHO group said their investigation was limited. It was not as intensive as they would like, but it was as much as the Chinese would give them. So this new group is just echoing the same thing. Say that was not a really complete evaluation. We don't think that happened. They even say that in the article. But, you know, we want a fuller investigation. That's all it's saying. You know, this is just going to go on because the Chinese are never going to let them come back and do what they want to do. And they're going to just close the door. And then they're going to have this argument back and forth. And then, you know, let's deal with what's going on today. You know, we got to work on this, you know, our pandemic here and opening things back up, getting vaccinated, maybe modifying the vaccine, getting a super booster. You know, that's where we're going. That's reality. Let's try to stay in the present reality state.
All right, a couple of viewer questions. Several women in my outdoor walking group tested positive for COVID, even though we are all vaccinated more than a month ago. I tested negative. Is it okay for me to watch my four-year-old grandson?
Yes, it is. It's totally okay. We don't know how infectious those, like I mentioned before, we don't know how infectious those people are because they were vaccinated. They probably were in much less infectious than a person who has COVID, who has just virus all over the place for many days. Even the COVID patients are not so infectious after 10 days. That's why the quarantine was 10 days. So the vaccinated people is much shorter than that. So yeah, it's okay. Gotcha.
All right. Here we go. When is Moderna going to come out with their vaccine for children?
Well, Moderna has, they have two big studies going on that I've been able to just investigate. One in, you know, they're approved for 18 and up. So they have one for 12 to 17. I think there's 1,500 people in that, children in that. I'm not sure the exact number. But they also have another study I read from an investigator from Yale. 6 months to 11 years of age, there's, I wrote the number down here, 6,750 of them, children in that particular study. Those are ongoing, 90 sites in Canada and the U.S. So, you know, it'll take a couple months to get that through, but it's in progress.
All right. If you have a question for Dr. Murphy, head to our Morning News Facebook page, post it there. We'll talk to him again on Monday. Have a great weekend.
You're vaccinated. I'm vaccinated. So.
Thanks, doctor.
Thanks, doctor.